the drummer get wicked. Hear the drummer get wicked. Hear the drummer get wicked. Wicked, 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 wicked.
Buddy, what's going on? We're here with Mr. Boston Accent. We're doing a Bluefish today. Not too many people like Bluefish, not a lot, but some do. People complain that since it's a fish that eats other fish, it's too oily, it's too greasy, it's too fishy. Now, if you want to get some omega vitamins and amino acids and good oils in your system, one of the best ways to do it is to have Bluefish. Now, I'm in New England, I'm in Boston, right? And I got a new Bluefish. These fish, they're native to these parts. They get to be like that big. They're huge. They eat striped bass. They have huge teeth on them. So I'm selective about getting it because it is fishy. It could stink up your house. You know a fish is fresh when it could do this and it flops down. You know, you can still like... It's still going. Also, its eye. See how clear its eye is? Nice clear eyes. It's good to go. What did I do? I cut the fin off here. I cut the tail, part of the tail off there. The fins right here I cut off. I open them up. Sorry, I open them up right here and take out all their intestines, the lemmings, pull it all out. That, I put in some a boiling water and I'm going to give it to the cat. Now, we're going to try to do this in a barbecue style at the house. I hope you enjoy it. Anybody who... The flavor should be good. All the ingredients are from the garden. I dried some dill earlier. I have that here. Da-na-na. I dried that. I have some more growing too. Black pepper. Simple stuff. It's not really rocket sometimes. That extra, you know, like... grainy taste will melt in your saliva and it's awesome. Anyway, then I have a tab of butter. You're gonna see what I'm gonna do with the butter. I'm gonna take out, I have that oven preheated at 400, right? I'm gonna take out a little tiny cast iron pan. It's already hot from being in there, being preheated. I'm gonna leave it on the stove, throw the butter in it, right? And then I have my Italian dried spices that I always use. Boom, a little bit in that. When it gets really hot, I'll put a little cream in there, and then that will be my like my extra sauce. When I have a piece of the fish, I'm going to be able to spoon in a little, just ladle a little bit in just to get a little extra taste. Now, it's not necessarily super healthy to eat like this because of this, you know, the butter and everything else, but I'm not having a starch with it. I'm actually going to have a salad and a salad only. I'm not even going to have bread with this, and that's about it. And let's do it. Let's get into the Bluefish. If you notice, when I was cutting that, I went down to the bone, so when the meat is done, it's gonna lift right off. At any rate, I cut these yesterday. These are shoots from garlics, little garlics I have growing out back. They have like a green sprout and then they double up like that. They taste awesome. So I'm gonna cut these up. I'm gonna take the dill, pepper, salt, and I'm gonna let it drop inside the cracks. Wrap it up in tin foil, throw it in the bin. Thank you. leave the head out and the tail out a little bit. So when it's cooked and we can see like the teeth come out and the little bones and the fin come out. It's one way of telling it's done. I'm gonna put it in the oven now. All right, so let's see how the fish looks.
On the front, why? Jump up and get bucked. If you're feeling lucky duck, then press your luck. I snatch fake gangster and...